to your death!
Once again by me, 3D,
and also by me, and I'm known as Guido.
Before we begin tonight's card, we would like to announce that we have three special guest superstars in the house tonight. The first is from television's Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous. This is Mr. Robin Leach.
That's right, Juggalos, here he comes, Mr. Robin Leach. No imitators here, no impersonators. That's Robin Leach, goddammit.
There he is, ladies and gentlemen. Thurston Howell III in person.
Now you shut the fuck up, it's Robin Leach. It took me 4 months to get him in the JCW.
The next celebrity superstar that we'd like to introduce is pop music sensation, RuPaul.
Right there, Guido. Right there is a prime piece of ass, if you ask me.
Oh, my God. What the fuck is wrong with your brain, 3D? Look at that.
Oh, look at those tits. Look at those tits.
Jesus Christ, she'll make a fucking bitch out of you if you let her.
What I wouldn't do palming that big, juicy ass, let me tell you.
She'll palm your balls in her mouth and face.
The biggest of superstars. He has sold over 50 million albums worldwide. Please welcome the King of Pop. This is Michael Jackson.
I'm starting. Oh, my God, it is him.
The moves. Look at the moves.
Wow. I happen to know, Guido, that JCW paid a whopping $500 to bring him in from the Never Never Valley Ranch.
That's right. The King of Pop, as I like to call him, Jacko.
Wow. All right, let's go down to Sirius Darius, standing by with Madman Hondo.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Sirius Darius here once again. And now I'm going to interview a man you've seen on the previous two tapes. You may have seen him live. You may have seen him all over the country, for he is a worldwide famous wrestler. I give you, from the realm of pain, the madman himself, Madman Pondo. Mr. Pondo, I've heard that you've had some problems with the Insane Clown Posse on this tour. Mr. Dope, Mr. J, would you care to comment?
The Insane Clown Posse is not an understatement. The problem I'm with the Insane Clown Posse, I think that they get dick. Why do I think they get dick? Because they fucked me. They fucked me hard. I signed a contract for $1,250. They moved my decimal. Now I'm making $12.50. I'm killing my fucking self. $12.50. Look, I am Madman Pondo. The Insane Clown Posse thinks they got another idiot that's going to take me down. But I'm fucking his world up too, and you'll be next if you fuck around.
Some very choice words by Madman Pondo, 3D.
The following matchup is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Ass Lick, Kentucky, weighing 725 fucking pounds.
Wow!
Horn swaggling.
This man, Guido, This man is an enormous mountain of loop.
It's more than loop 3D. It's marshmallow jelly pumped in right into his fucking fat ass.
Serious, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Kool-Aid Man. Kool-Aid Jug Man, boy, man.
That's right, and you'll notice the ass on the front of his pants. See, Guido always has the inside scoop. I happen to know that that's King Kong Bundy stuffed down the front of his trousers, and that's his ass protruding out, looking like a bubble.
You don't happen to know anything. That's purely speculation at this point. Look at him. Look at the physical agility. Look at the physical skills of that man as he climbs into the ring.
It almost looks like he's floating up them stairs with the grace and the agility that he possesses.
Like a bittersweet angel, Guido.
That's right. Very lovely and handsome.
Look at the butt. Now he's going to wear that rope like a thong.
He's
right
going to get
the butt of King Kong Bundy.
He's going to get King Kong Bundy pissed, and he is going to come out and get him disqualified.
See, there's the butt. There's the butt at the bottom of his stomach. You see the butt crack, ladies and gentlemen. Many people believe that's King Kong Bundy hiding in his trousers for extra agility and weight on the part of Haystacks.
Here comes his opponent.
Another psychopathic employee.
Oh, no, it can't be.
Now, Guido, you better tell me something right now. What the fuck is Tom Doug thinking? Thinking he can get in the ring with 750 pounds of loopy jello. What the fuck? Look at Tom Doug. He's so skinny, he sags his spandex.
I know. I'm thinking beyond that. Not only am I thinking what Tom Doug's fucking thinking, signing this match, I'm thinking what the fuck the promoters of JCW were thinking when they just inked the whole fucking match in general, 3D.
Tom Doug is the only person I know that can wear biker shorts baggy. Look at him. He looks like a cigarette with two arms coming off him. There he is.
He shows the super physique off, then goes right on the attack. Ow, the possum punch.
You see Tom Dub there wiggling the jelly insides of enormous Haystacks hornswoggling hillbilly.
That's the whole secret. He wasn't even punching Haystacks. He was punching King Kong Bundy in the ass.
Tom Dub on the comeback. Oh, that was short-lived. Now, wait a minute, Guido. I can tell you right now the match is about to end because I have no doubt in my mind that Haystacks is blown up and winded.
I thought he was going to the top rope and do his patented 420 move.
Well, he is known for hurricanranas and moonsaults off the lighting ring at times. But today, against a skinny, feeble old like Tom Dub, he's just going to drop that human ass on the front of his stomach.
900 pounds of human ass, not including the rest of his body. That's just the ass protruding off the front of his overalls, ladies and gentlemen.
It looks to me like somebody stuck a fire hose right up his fucking anus and pumped him full of jelly and whipped cream and soft jello materials.
And soft silicone products. Now that third splash right there, I happen to know Tom Dumb shit himself, but he didn't shit. He shit in his lungs, spleen, and his kidney.
Tom Dub's ribcage was turned into powdery dust after that third splash as you see Hornswoggling Hillbilly blew up on the outside of the ring. Now, Hornswoggling Hillbilly is known for his aerial moves. He is, if you will, or if you won't, he is an athletic specimen of epic proportions.
Tom Dub is very lucky that Hornswoggling Hillbilly just kept it to the splash. Nicey Patrick trying to help Dub up. He needs to get a fucking paramedic. Patrick is not a licensed physician, goddammit.
Now, Tom Dub works for a record label. He works for Psychopathic Records. He is not an athlete. That's where he's wrong. Hornswoggling Hillbilly is an athlete. You can tell by looking at him.
It's true. Right now, let's go down to Serious Darius Bagfeld, joined by the Honky Tonk Man.
What kind of song do you want the Honky Tonk Man to sing tonight?
Hocus Pocus.
Hocus Pocus. What the hell is that?
Oh, Mr. Man, Serious Darius.
Wait a minute, what did you say? Chicken what? Chicken shit?
Chicken hunting.
Chicken hunting? The Honky Tonk Man. Hey, I'm hunting chickens. I'm hunting insane clowns. Hey, chickens. That's who I'm hunting. That's not the kind of music the Honky Tonk Man knows how to play, brother. I'm into real rock and roll.
Yes, Mr. Man, how do you feel about being in the JCW? It's well known your past with other wrestling federations. It's well known your past with, the music industry. How do you feel about being in this JCW event here this evening in Milwaukee?
Well, first of all, you call me the greatest of all time. See, I sing, I dance, and of course I play the guitar. That's something the Insane Clown Posse does not do. You see, when the Honky Tonk Man rolls into town, they want to hear rock and roll. They want to see 59 pink Cadillacs. We don't want to hear chicken scratch, chicken shit, or any of that stuff that JCW puts on. Psychopathic Records is nothing but garbage, and the Honky Tonk Man said so, Juggalos.
Well, 3D.
Is the special Who the Fuck Are These Guys match?
All right. Here it comes. He said it all right there.
Introducing first, from the Highlands, this is Isaiah.
All right. Everybody knows who that guy is.
A super name to go along with a super ninja.
With a super gimmick.
Yes.
See, his gimmick is that, well, he comes to the ring and the Honky Tonk Man said so, Juggalos.
Cause he said so, Juggalos.
Now,
from the Metropolis,
here he comes.
This is Chris Hero.
Now, this motherfucker Chris Hero, I know the whole inside scoop on him. His name used to be Chris Hoagie. That wasn't getting over. He switched it to Chris Grinder. Now, that wasn't getting over. For all his homosexual fans, he's now called Chris Hero.
Chris Homo.
That's right, Bicurious Hero.
Bicurious Homo, that's his name.
And here he comes, Piss Taco.
Now look at Chris Hero. You can see the gimmick is, well, both of these gentlemen, Guido, have absolute wonderful gimmicks. They're going big places in wrestling.
I'm gonna go ahead and say they had lots of heart in their wrestling outfits as well. Shut the fuck up!
Said so, Juggalos.
If Chris Ryder, Mitch Ryder, grabs that mic one more time, I'm gonna fucking flip his ass like Isaiah.
Now there you see Isaiah throwing Lenny Hero over the ropes, and well, you know, basically let's cut to the point. This is what all Juggalos have been waiting for, is this match.
Oh my goodness, good aerial move. You know what? He jacked that move off the Hornswoggling Hillbilly.
That's right. The Hornswoggling Hillbilly is a lot more lighter on his feet. Now, looking at the Horn, let's talk more about him. Looking at the Hornswoggling Hillbilly, you'd think that his feet are blew out and his toes look somewhat like tennis rackets or something. But in fact, the Hornswoggling Hillbilly is very much light on his feet, unlike these two fucking idiots that are lazy and untrained in the sport of wrestling.
You're crazy. These guys have skills matched by no other.
Look at that selling technique. Look at how real that looks. He's hurt.
Parkea is the smoothest butter. The Green Arrow, I don't know about him too much, but I do know that...
The Green Arrow off the top rope. Boom. Chicken frog splash.
Chicken frog splash. Now back to our Hornswoggling Hillbilly. You were mentioning his feet look like tennis rackets. That's some bullshit.
His toes look like tennis rackets because they're blew out.
I seen him take his socks off once and his feet look like moon boots. Don't let that fool you, though. The moon boots provide a soft, cushiony landing for when he walks. It's like he walks on trampoline.
Now, wait a minute. Enough about him. Let's get back to Chris Zero and Isaiah.
Isaiah's busted open. I guess Mia Farrow was the cause of all that juice.
Now, wait a minute. I happen to know that the Insane Clown Posse offered an additional $500 to anybody that bleeds that night.
Actually, I think it was more like 50, but I'll keep my mouth shut.
Now, you see, I'll give you a little bit of history on both of these men. Isaiah, the guy with the silver in the expensive wrestling uniform, Isaiah, in fact, works at an Arby's in Gusto, Ohio, where he makes mocha shakes and... Giant Supers.
I want you to quit cutting down on his wrestling uniform. You know, Walmart costs a lot of money for wrestling uniforms nowadays, 3D.
Now, let me tell you something about Isaiah Thomas. Everybody knows he once played for the Detroit Pistons, but now he is a wrestler, and you see he's wearing dress pants along with his poo-boo shirtless top.
Well, I like his Giorgio Brutini shoes. They really set the whole Walmart thing off, 3D.
Now, let's talk about Christopher Leno. Christopher Hero, in fact, works at a Walgreens. department store. He learned about wrestling through stocking the wrestling magazines in the magazine aisle.
And the WCW figures as well.
That's right. Now there you see Patrick handing him a chair.
Patrick was obviously scared of Piss Taco. He thought Piss Taco was going to go to the top rope and do a 460 moonflip onto Isaiah.
Now the thing about Christopher Reeves right here is the fact that he is very capable with the chair. Now watch this. He sets the chair gingerly on top of Isaiah.
Chris Farley's going up.
And he goes for what is known as the nobody moonsault.
That's right. Nobody's home.
That's right. And it's done, performed by a nobody.
Now I believe he knocked on the back door of Isaiah trying to get entrance, trying to get his passcode so he could dig up in his ass.
Wait a minute. I have a question, Guido. Is it true that, in fact, we saw Isaiah early in the show dressed as RuPaul at the beginning, coming out to the ring dressed like a woman?
You know what? That's how this whole feud started, because also, if you throw some chips glasses on Piss Taco, he will, in fact, look like Robin Leach. Perhaps both of them came out. They had a skirmish in the dressing room before this match, which led to this match right here, the dick in the mouth.
That's right. That was called the Eat My Pussy. That's what that was called.
Eat My Man Pussy.
That's not what I call it. That's what he calls it under his RuPaul gimmick, which is something he does to make cash on the side. Now, here goes a pin. One, two, no.
Thank God.
Yes. Whatever. All right, let's go down to something else because this.
I don't give a fuck what it is. Serious Darius, another match. Fucking Slick Rick Buggleface. I don't give a fuck.
Now get there's out your the man, camera, Victorious.
I don't see Raven's car no more.
Evil, come on. You got a match with Bundy tonight, brother. You're looking good.
Get him up.
Top physical condition, brother.
Get him up. I got him. Let's go.
Fucked up. I look like a Power Ranger and shit.
Yeah, ain't that the pot calling the kettle black? I look like my fucking mom had an affair with Bozo the Clown in this jackass gimmick again.
Look, I'm not even a fucking wrestler. Can somebody tell me where the fuck is Joe?
Shit. I'm supposed to be setting up the ring right now. Tell me, has anybody seen Billy?
They damn sure don't have no hog jaws and collard greens on the road either.
He is one big motherfucker. Hell no, you ain't about to hit it, Holmes.
Eshawn being a little stingy with the weed there, not wanting to give Hollywood Chuck Hogan any.
Well, so what? Right here, we got a double tables match.
In this match, you have to put your opponent through two tables in order to win.
Both two.
There's the rude boy in the crowd. Well, actually, not really, but.
Sharon Osborne's attorney, Mr. Dick Nippin.
Now, this man right here happens to be the attorney for Miss Sharon Osborne. And I happen to know, Guido, that if the attorney, right here, Dick Nipple, if Dick Nipple wins this match, he will get to serve papers to the Insane Clown Posse, which means ICP will have to go to court.
That's right. Right into court, right out of their pockets, the money will come out. Unless the man coming up next into the ring can stop him, which I don't think will be much of a problem. Dick Nipple, you faggot, quit manhandling the other faggot.
Listen, I'll tell you, that referee right there doesn't mind being handled by men. He enjoys being manhandled, if you will.
He loves men's handles.
Wheel it out there, Buggles. This man, Billy Bill, is going to make sure Dick Nibble doesn't serve anybody anything.
I don't think Dick Nibble's going to serve anything for the rest of his life, 3D.
However, Billy Bill is planning on serving Dick Nibble's frame through two of those tables, probably in less than 30 seconds.
That's right. He calls it the back sandwich. He makes his back a sandwich between two fucking tables. There
he plants Dick Nibble through one table like a seed into a fucking soft garden.
He's going for the second one.
Now he's going to plant Dick Nibble right through this table like a dick right through Tony Braxton's net.
Oh! His wig flies back and he's out of there.
That match is over with. It was so close. Dick Nibble came so close.
Let's go to some previous recorded interviews from Bicurious Faggot.
Here with Chris Hero from the metropolis of, from the metropolis of Metropolis, actually. Mr. Hero, do you have any thoughts on your match tonight against Isaiah?
You see this right here? It's out with the old and in with the new, because I'm the only hero.
Fuck JCW! I'm the only man you gotta worry about! I'm Madman Pondo! I'm fucking everybody up! They don't fuck with me! I don't fuck with...
Madman Pondo, don't you ever, ever fuck with a Serious Darius interview again, you little bitch!
St. Clown Posse still looking for their six-man tag team partner tonight, Raven.
I can never find his ass.
You know, it's Raven and IGP tonight versus those three faggots, Big Flame, Neil, and Bob.
Yes, and that's not just their gimmick.
Oh, shit.
Checking the toilet stalls.
Oh, shit.
Oh!
I'm sorry, brother.
No problem.
Nice!
Hollywood Chuck Hogan pinching a loaf.
Raven! Oh, hell no,
boy! Oh, my God! Big Flame, Neil, and Bob right there egging him on.
You gotta be gay to do something like that, 3D.
Let's get into this right now. We don't know if they'll ever find their partner or not, but let's get into this hardcore of hardcore matches.
And you couldn't have said it no better, 3D, if I would have said it myself.
We like the hardcore shit. Let's get into some fucking hardcore.
It doesn't come much more hardcore than this, motherfuckers. You got staple guns, you got barbed wire, everything.
This motherfucker, Madman Pondo, he likes to talk a lot of shit about Jay and Shaggy, the owners of JCW, when in fact, that's all a work. He's actually good friends of Jay and Shaggy's, but all that aside, he does have his pajamas on, and he's ready for action. He's got his fucking hockey player knee pads, his pajamas on, and his $8 Exorcist t-shirt. He's ready for action.
He scored that from the drive-in movie theater just recently. He went and saw The Exorcist, bought a value meal of popcorn, and got the shirt for half price,
please. That's right. Now, Madman Pancho is without a doubt feared from Japan to Sudan. But let's see who he's wrestling tonight in JCW.
From Barrelswagga, Mississippi.
Barrelswagga. Here he comes.
Fat Fuck Barry.
Now this is indubitably a Juggalo fan favorite right here, 3D.
On what?
On stupidubitably.
All right. Now here you got a big fat fuck in a barrel. What could be better for wrestling action? A fat guy in a fucking barrel. He's fat, he's a fuck, and he's in a barrel.
And he carries a barbed wire bat.
He's got a bat wrapped in barbed wire, throws it at Madman Plancho, takes off the barrel, revealing his guest jeans.
When you're a fat ass and you wear a barrel, 3D, you gotta carry a barbed wire bat for protection purposes. It's like a gay guy wearing a sailor suit. He's gotta carry some kind of protection.
Now notice, Fat Fuck Barrel Boy looking in tremendous physical shape.
I happen to know he does the 6-minute abs every day, as you can tell by the rock washboard stomach.
Rock washboard stomach.
There's Patrick!
All right, there's Patrick.
Okay, I just wanted to state that.
Now look at Poncho and Fat Fuck Barrel Boy locking up just inches away from the poisonous, venomous thumbtacks.
If Fat Fuck isn't careful, his stomach might hit those tacks while he's standing up, 3D.
It could, but the rock washboard will not be penetrated by nothing, especially a thumbtack.
If a tack hits it, it's just liable to bend in half and hit Pondo in the ass instead of Fat Fuck Barrel Boy's stomach.
Now watch out, Fat Fuck, you Fat Fuck!
Ow! Early in the match with the stop sign, and the skids are prevailing.
Did I mention this match is just highlights?
Oh, yeah, I noticed by that shit that just happened right there. Oh, my God, what in the back?
Staple guns right to the flabby back of Fat Fuck.
Now, we had to cut this down to highlights because it took him about a half hour to get that staple gun out. This way, he didn't waste no fucking time. Here comes the money shot.
Staple gunning dollar bills to the forehead. Pondo thinks it's on there, but it's not. Wait, he's going to put it back on there, make sure it stays this time.
It was just sticking to the blood. This time, a staple goes in and holds it to its fucking gashed forehead.
Now, I happen to know some secret information, Guido. Fat Fuck Barrel Boy, when he's not fat and he's not fucking around in a barrel, he in fact wrestles as Mean Mitch Page all over the United States as well as Japan, and he's feared and he's fucking scary as hell.
That's right, a very noted, renowned wrestler, Mitch Ryder.
Oh my God, look at the fucking dollar bill stuck to the face of Madman Pondo. These two have invented hardcore. These two are for real hardcore. That is a real staple gun, a real barbed wire bat, and the fat surrounding the stomach area of Fat Fuck Barrel Boy is real as well.
Now let me tell you something right here, 3D. These two motherfuckers right here will do anything in a hardcore match that takes to put on a good fucking show for the Juggalos. They'll wrestle in fluorescent light bulbs. They'll wrestle in barbed wire. They'll wrestle in dollar bills stapled to their face.
They'll wrestle in baby oil completely naked.
That's right, he'll take the skids off, revealing that he's got pig balls.
That's right. Now wait a minute. Is it true that both of these guys are actually good friends of Insane Clown Posse, as well as good friends of each other, and they're just doing this for the entertainment value?
Well, I believe they might be friends of them, but that doesn't stop them from not going to the gym a day in their life.
Fat Fuck Barrel Boy looking great!
There it is! No reaching leg sweeping to the thumbtacks!
Fat Fuck Barrel Boy looking in tremendous physical condition. That is what athlete is all about. That is what athleticism is made from right there. A big fat fuck and a pair of fucking cutoff chicks.
What's going on here? He's on the top rope. Fat Fuck grabs his ass.
Reversal.
Oh my God.
And Pondo doesn't even take the bump. He just lands his feet and attacks the lazy fuck.
I think he caught about three or four in the cheek.
He's got dollar bills hanging off his ugly face. Pondo is going to merge with one of the thumbtacks. Oh my God.
I'll have you know, 3D, that's the reason why they staple gun dollars to their cheeks, is because that's all they're getting paid is the dollars they staple.
That's right. Them. That's why they yell for dollars from the crowd. They're looking for a bonus. But right here, Fat Buck going for his patented move,
oh,
the pig slop drop, and there it was.
There it goes. They slop the pig drop.
Now,
he's going up for it again.
He's going for the Hurricane Rana Palooza Monsault. There it goes. Oh.
Oh my God, he catches five tacks right into the fucking stomach. Luckily, the ripped washboard wouldn't allow the tacks to penetrate.
Now right here, Pondo's got the barbed wire bat, and in fact is raking it across the droopy, sweaty back of Fat Fuck Barrel Boy.
He's rubbing it across the forehead of Fat Fuck as if he had teeth on his forehead and he's brushing them.
Ladies and gentlemen, Fat Fuck Barrel Boy. Barrel Boy.
If Fat Fuck doesn't pull his pants up soon, his ass crack's gonna be hanging out.
He staple gunned the nutsack right to the inner thigh of Fat Fuck Barrel Boy.
They hit him in his Fat Fuck balls.
Right there, another staple gun right to the penis and the itch area of Fat Fuck Barrel Boy.
Now I wanna point something out to you, 3D.
Is it about Fat Fuck Barrel Boy?
Well, yes, it is. As a matter of fact, it is about Fat Fuck. I just want to note how little he's getting paid. Now, you notice the skids in the Exorcist Chachi on Catman Poncho.
Now, wait a minute.
I see the $30 tattoo on the fat fucking stomach of Fat Fuck Barrel Boy.
Now, you mentioned the skids that Madman Pondo's wearing. However, I think that Fat Fuck Barrel Boy will be wearing the skids in his drawers right after Pondo lands on him from 45 feet in the air.
After this movie, he's going to have more than skids, brother. He's going to have dirt roads.
Now right there, you got Madman Pondo, 45 feet in the air, a house packed full of Juggalos that want to see Madman Pondo land on Fat Fuck
Barrel Boy.
An ocean of juggalos wanting to see the mayhem, wanting to see the blood.
Say it with me.
Wanting to see Pondo to kill him. Fat fuck Barrel Boy.
Fat fuck.
He's about to be dead fuck Barrel Boy in a second.
I can't believe what Pondo's getting ready to do in front of this sold-out crowd in Milwaukee.
He's scared to jump up in the air. He hang drops. Oh, my God.
Holy shit.
That's got to be it, 3D.
He landed right on Fat Fuck Barrel Boy.
You see the gay ginger taps by the referee on the floor.
Yes, the ginger count from the feminine referee was 1, 2, 3. And Fat Fuck Barrel Boy has lost his match. And Madman Pondo is going back to collect the $25 he made tonight.
Madman Pondo might have won this match, but he's not fucking done yet, 3D. He's got something to say to somebody.
I told you. Right up there with the career of an Eight Vanilla Ice. Because they both fucking suck.
Talking more shit about ICP.
What the fuck does Vanilla Ice got to do with anything? That fuck doesn't appreciate this.
How would you like to tell somebody to their face how bad they suck?
Who's he got with him? What's going on?
I have no idea.
Vanilla Ice.
That's the fuck of it. It's Rob Van Winkle. It's the Iceman himself.
It's Robert Van Winkle. Vanilla Ice in person.
Nutsack Van Winkle.
12 million albums. The Iceman cometh. And now they're beating the shit out of Madman Pondo.
Look at the tremendous physique on Vanilla Ice.
Whoa! And he wrapped the fucking stop sign around the head of Pondo. The stop sign is shaped like an army helmet. And there he is, the Iceman. The funky white boy, if you will.
There it goes again. I like to call him Robbie Twice as Nice Ice.
That's right. Now, Pondo is receiving a beating much like Vanilla Ice did at the hands of Suge Knight. Purely speculation at this point.
Now I'm going to make some more speculation. Oh my God, there goes the third one. I'm going to make some pure speculation here. I just don't really see Fat Fuck Barrel Boy and Vanilla Ice just hanging out normally. I'm going to go ahead and say this was set up.
Well, it might have been set up. But right now, you've got Fat Fuck Barrel Boy and Vanilla Ice having their way with the human punching bag, Madman Pondo.
Let's just hope Vanilla Ice doesn't have his way with Madman Pondo the way Suge Knight did him.
If that was the case, Pondo's pants would be pulled down to his ankle and his thong would be pulled over to the side of the left butt cheek.
That's right, exposing the pig balls, exposing the red eye, with Vanilla Ice ready to mount.
No, wait a minute. That's purely speculation. Now, Fat Fuck Barrel Boy is in the ring.
Right in the fucking cheek. Oh my God, it falls off. Vanilla Ice forgot to put the staples in.
He forgot to put the staples in, but Suge Knight did not forget.
He does not need the staples, though, because he uses his ice freezing power and freezes it to his fucking face.
Now, Vanilla Ice can't get no satisfaction, and he's taking it out on the pig nose of Madman Pondo. Unfucking believable.
Play that funky stapler, white boy.
Minute. Vanilla Ice is going to bang his butthole out like Suge Knight did him. Wait, I didn't say that.
3D, this is the death match right here. We've all been waiting for the big rematch. Now, word on the streets is we have a special guest commentator with us.
We do have a special guest.
That's the word around the campfire, goddammit.
We do have a special guest, and you're looking at him right now on the screen, as well as right next to us, none other than the Rude Boy!
There he is!
What's up, 3D? What's up, Guido?
Hi, Rudy!
I might be a little drunk, but hey, I don't give a fuck, okay? Hey, you wanted me to come out here, you wanted me to shake my ass for a little while with the Juggalos, I'm cool with that.
Now there's a true trooper right there. 8:30 in the morning, this motherfucker's already tipped back Grandpa's fucking cough medicine.
There he is right there, getting into the 15-foot high steel fucking cage, none other than the fucking Rude Boy. Rude Boy, last time you on JCW Volume 1, you came so close to defeating Abdullah the Butcher. You were within.
Just shut the fuck up. I'm going to clear shit up right now. Rude Boy, what the fuck were you thinking? Getting in that cage the way your face got plummeted the last match. You decided to take a rematch in the steel cage. What the fuck is going through your head?
I'd like to first thank Shags and Jay for putting me in the cage. You know, they're real good fucking friends of mine.
Well, shut up! Ain't the contract. You're the one that signed it, asshole.
Shut the fuck up. Here comes... Oh, they're going to give the manager to Fat Dumpling Cook.
Now look at this big fat fucking retard with
shut
his
up.
Stupid orange hat.
Let Fat Dumpling Man talk.
He's going to have a fucking heart attack.
That's Abdullah's manager. He's known as the Fat Pastry Chef. If you push his stomach, he goes,
he makes a fucking mean cream cake donut, I'll tell you.
He makes a mean cannoli on top of that 3D.
There he is, Abdullah the
My first thought when I seen Abdullah coming down the ramp was, damn, he looked like a big fat-ass Hershey's Kiss.
He looks somewhat like a big, lovable, stuffed man.
He looks like a chewed-up Reese's cup.
He looks to me like a giant duck with tits. And I fucking love Abdullah the fat fuck.
Yes, once again back, the big chocolate duck.
Now, right there, Rude Boy. Now, you were so close in almost defeating the madman from the Sudan in the last JCW. Now, you were so close that you demanded this rematch inside the steel cage.
Now, hold on. Before you answer that, Rude Boy.
I didn't even ask a question yet.
Well, fuck you. Now, the last match you had with Abdullah, you at least threw a couple punches. Even though he didn't sell them, you still threw them. This match, you didn't get one fucking blow in.
We didn't.
Explain yourself.
Well, it's like this, Guido in 3D. Check it out. All through the whole night, we had everything worked out in the back dressing room. But then when we got out there, he
so
just...
So you're saying wrestling's fake and set up?
Is that what you're saying, wrestling is fake?
Is that what I said?
You said you had everything worked out.
In so many words, wrestling is fake.
No, it's not. That blood is very real.
I've been on that squared circle, goddammit. There's nothing fake about it.
Now, wait a minute. Right there, you see the giant panda duck sticking his fork into the fucking face. Now, wait a minute. What happened to the mullet? The last JCW Volume 1, you had a long, beautiful mullet, and here you seem to have shaved the hair. Explain that.
I can tell you why, because it's 2000, not 1980.
Well, that's why I didn't have my powers, see? I didn't even get to throw a couple punches because I didn't have the power.
Yes, you're right. The first match, you blinded him with the mullet and got 3 punches in.
Now, wait a minute. Are you guys going to get in the cage, or are you just going to walk around blown up outside of the ring like both of you are doing right now? Answer!
Answer, you fucking asshole!
Look, I'm trying to get in the fucking cage, but I'm also trying to pick up the powder that we worked out in the back dressing room as
I
well.
I think you're too busy cutting your forehead open with a razor blade.
That's purely speculation, Guido. God damn it.
I didn't even say
what
that.
What the hell is that in your pocket?
I told you, I'm trying to pick up the fucking powder.
He's got a baggie full of sandwiches for Abdullah, and he didn't want them.
I think the fat pastry chef dropped some of his flour dough. Oh, my God. There's the fork. He's going to fucking eat the pastries that the fat dough boy made.
He tried to pull out the pre-cut cookie dough to distract Abdullah the Butcher's fat ass. Well, he got one blowing, but he dropped it and fucked the whole match up.
Now, how much money did you get for this match, Rude Boy? And don't speculate.
How much did I get for this match?
Yes.
I got a mere $1,000.
So you made $1,000 to get in the ring with Abdullah the Butcher and have your face reputedly stabbed with the fork.
But now hold
on. With 4 days in the Milwaukee hospital as well.
He drank at least $500 more worth of beer, though.
That's right. So I think you owe us, in fact, $500.
And perhaps 2 bottles of whiskey.
$500? God damn it.
Now, wait a minute. Right there. Was he trying to pick the food out of your teeth so he could eat it himself?
That's why he's got the fork. He picks it out with the fork and eats it.
That's right.
You can tell as I'm tapping the cage that I'm telling him you're hurting me for real, fuck.
Now, Abdullah the Butcher's titty nipples look like giant Hershey's Kisses.
They do. In fact, his titties look like 2 giant pizzas he's holding under his arms.
They look like the chocolate chip pancakes from IHOP.
Wait a fucking minute. Did you talk to the duck before the match and work out the angle, or did he just stab you in the ring?
Before the match, he was the nicest gentleman that I've ever met in my life.
That's right.
Then when we got in the ring, he kept saying, come on, hardcore. Come on, fucking
That's
hardcore.
That's because he's the madman from the Sudan, dumbass.
Did you ever eat at
He's a 70-year-old hardcore legend.
He owns a barbecue pit in Atlanta.
Did you ever eat at the Abdullah's House of Chinese Ribs and Rude Boy Ribs?
I felt like I was eating right there.
Well, he's got Rude Boy ribs on the menu now.
Ow!
Oh, my goodness. That was real as
that
fuck.
That was an awesome bump, Rude Boy.
You're trying to tell me wrestling's fake, and clearly I just seen that fork go right into
Barry's
your fucking
throwing
forehead.
A beer to the fucking Abdullah the Butcher.
He grabs a beer bottle and breaks it.
Oh, my God. Wait a minute. That's not fake, is it?
He's going to attack him with it.
Rude Boy, that's a real beer bottle. No.
Oh my God.
Rude Boy.
Now,
how much
I know that beer bottle hurt, but I'm going to go ahead and say you oversold it.
How much did that wife beater cost you're wearing?
Well, it didn't cost as much as the fucking hospital bill I still have.
It sure didn't, because you borrowed it from Mitch Ryder.
I think you borrowed that very same...
Fat Fuck Barrel Boy.
You borrowed that from Mitch Page, Fat Fuck Barrel Boy, and you got bloodstains on it, and he's pissed. Now, wait a minute. What the hell is Abdullah the Butcher wearing?
wrapped around his big duck ass.
That's his purple cummerbund.
No, that would be a girdle right under his purple cummerbund.
The purple cummerbund is, in fact, holding up the black tent of the pants that wrap around the huge duck ass of a man.
Now, Rude Boy, I have one more question for you. Now, obviously, he lets you go for a couple seconds there. Why did you not run for the door to win the match?
Well, to be honest with you, I was almost passed out due to loss of blood.
I know you weren't scheduled to win the match, damn it. But he wasn't scheduled to stab you with a fucking beer bottle either.
Abdullah's blew up from beating your ass, Rude Boy. He's been beating your ass so hard and so fast that he's winded.
He didn't even take one bump.
And then before the match,
nice leg action
he asked,
there.
Oh, that hurt.
The Sudanese meat cleaver.
Before the match, he asked Billy Bill for a couple shots of tequila so he could bleed really, really well.
Right.
Little did he know, he just wanted to cut me more and more.
Little did you know, he slipped that tequila into your 40.
Now, Rude Boy, shut the fuck up and explain to me this. What were you doing with your leg when you're tapping it on the mat seconds before Abdullah dropped?
That's muscular contusions, you fucking idiot. He just got stabbed with a beer bottle.
Thank you, my friend.
Now, wait a minute. Where's Fat Pastry Ass? There he is. He's throwing something in the ring.
He's in the kitchen.
And he's the one who has the mullet now.
He's in the kitchen cooking cannolis, goddammit.
Oh, my God. He's putting that fucking rope around your neck. What is he trying to accomplish right now, Rude Boy?
He just wants to show everybody that he's an 84-year-old hardcore legend.
It's a pure case of adding insult to injury, if you ask me.
What are you doing massaging his shoulders while he's choking you?
You're rubbing his titty, Rude Boy. Look
Explain
at that rubbing
that.
Action.
Explain
Look,
that.
There's my hint, see?
At least have the decency to put some baby oil in your hand, you asshole.
What the fuck was that soft ginger pat you were doing to his enormous nipple?
He tried twisting his nipple to turn him on so maybe he could escape.
I can't believe what I'm seeing, Rude Boy.
There is no escape when it comes to Abdullah the Butcher.
You could have just ran right around him and ran out the door.
Rude Boy, you came so close in this match once again. Damn it, you earned that $1,000 as well as that $35,000 hospital bill. Look at the beautiful chicks. Absolutely
gorgeous. Well, Rude Boy, it was wonderful for you to join us once again, even though we just sat here and witnessed you get your fucking ass whipped.
Rude Boy, you were closer this time, if I might go on record. You were closer.
You were two punches closer to a victory.
You were so close.
I'd like to thank you assholes for letting me talk this time.
Hey, why don't you do us all a favor and go fuck yourself?
Because I'm out of here. Fuck you guys.
Get the fuck out of here. There he is, the hardcore legend, hanging from a rope in the middle of the fucking doorway by Abdul the Butcher.
3D, right now, I would like to go down and take us to a special... Special.
Look at that
motherfucker.
He's still
trying to hang him.
The big fat fuck duck. That's what we should have called Abdullah. The fat fuck duck from fucking Chinese House of Ribs and Food in Atlanta, New Jersey.
That's right. Now, like I was saying, we want to take you down right now to a very special. Will you shut the fuck up?
Wait, just look at him for a second.
He's lucky he edited out the part where he's cutting himself some more.
Look at him. Oh,
hey, you could have did that 10 minutes
big
ago.
Bump. Big bump. Nice white
Jesus
beater.
Jesus Christ. Now, anyhow, like I was saying, it's time to go down to a very special music video that was edited and put together. There he goes, the pastry boy. Edited and put together for all you juggalos.
Welcome to Slagomania Live!
I talk too much. I don't care. I talk too much. Mama say I failed in life. I don't care. I failed in life. Daddy says I drink too much. I don't care. I drink too much. People say I'm headed nowhere, and I don't fucking care. Jimmy Johnson's gonna die. Sarah Susie's gonna die. Everybody's dying slow. I don't give a fuck. I'm only short like 50 bucks. I couldn't give 50 fucks. I could really use some help. You could go and fuck yourself. Ooh. Everybody's gonna die. Terror falling from the sky. Mothers with their children crying. I could give a fuck why. They say you'll never walk again. Well, like the Sega M. I think somebody stole my truck. Tell someone who gives a fuck. Do they charge in there? Wait a minute,
I don't care.
I'ma shoot you in the face.
I'll tell you how the bullets
come
taste. Critics say you imitate.
I don't give a fuck, you late.
No 50 million people dying.
Oh, I'm crying.
Tell me all the things you saw as if I give a fuck at all.
You see me sitting in the chair, yeah, but I ain't even there.
Everything you saying to me, go right through me. If I was to pick it up, I'd have to give a fuck.
And I don't care about you, not about you, not about you.
Down, born riots all around.
I'm inside like, fuck them all. What's the main event on Raw?
Poison, mad cow disease.
Can I get that with double cheese?
STD steady spreading.
Bear back up in this net.
I don't care.
If I survive, give it to me point blank. Bet it.
Did you hit him?
Yes, and I don't give a fuck less.
Careful, it's a dark night.
Get your money or your life.
Taking both for all I care. Dump your bullets right here.
Come on. Notice on the door.
Addicted, crawling on the floor.
Ask me, did I ever care?
Nah.
That video was just fucking nuts, but not half as nuts as what's about to go on right here before your eyes.
The motherfucking main event.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following matchup is your main event of the evening.
Right out of Bugaboo's mouth.
I'm ready for this.
First, representing the Rainbow Coalition.
You know what that means.
From Pebble Beach, Florida, Big Flame, Neil, and Bob.
Let me say this right now, Guido.
Shoot.
I have a surprise for you. Big Flame, Neil, and Bob were so upset that this match took place in Cleveland, Ohio, in front of all the Juggalos, that they absolutely demanded Volume 2's main event take place in front of a neutral crowd. So we are not about to show this match from Cleveland, Guido.
Well, actually, 3D, we show the entrances.
We show the entrances, but however, we are going to Sydney, Australia, to a neutral crowd where ICP and Evil Dead battled Big Flame, Neil, and Bob, and nobody knew about it. It was a surprise show, so we're just showing the entrances.
That's right, halfway across the globe from the Galapagos Islands.
First of all, let these faggots get in the ring and do their thing.
He's shaking his faggot ass. Oh my God, that's a disgusting fucking view. His fucking stomach looks like a bowl of melted marshmallows. Marshmallow pudding. Here they come.
See, in Cleveland, their partner was Isham. However, we are not going to show this match basically because it sucked. We are instead going to show what happened in Sydney, Australia, when it was Insane Clown Posse and Evil Dead versus Big Flame, Neil, and Bob.
Well, it appears that Isham gets a free plug out of this one, 3D, huh?
That's right. And on Overture Records, he could use it. Now, wait a minute. Let's talk more about what happened in Cleveland. This match was unbelievable. Isham and ICP fucking schooled it. The Juggalos loved it. However, Big Flame, Neil, and Bob were so upset because the fans were so one-sided. They were all juggalos. They felt it threw off their concentration, Greedo.
You know, 3D, I couldn't help but notice that Shaggy's got a neck brace on.
So what? Now, this match, in fact, ICP and Isham were victorious, but we're going to Sydney, Australia to show you that footage of what happened in Sydney when there was no juggalos in the crowd. There was no faggots in the crowd there to cheer on Big Flame Neil and Bob. In fact, it was a total neutral crowd. And let's go to that footage right after we show the warm introduction on the part of Shaggy and Jay and Isham the Unholy.
Well, not to ruin any expectations or anything, but I'm pretty sure every single time that Jay and Shaggy wrestled the three fags, no matter who their triple tag team partner was, I'm going to go ahead and say they won. I mean, not to ruin the ending or nothing,
no.
But I just can't see them taking the
What's
loss
he doing
to
out
a
there?
Big marshmallow faggot.
Now, wait a minute. They've teamed with Too Tough Tony. They teamed with Evil Dead. They teamed with Isham. They teamed with the Rude Boy. They always beat those three pink fudge fondlers.
I see the Juggalos running rapid, but here goes the problem. In just seconds here, we're going to cut out to the other match. Listen to the response. Warm response from the Juggalos to Jay.
That's exactly why Big Flame Neil and Bob were upset. They said they could not concentrate enough.
Well, they're crybaby pussy butts.
That might be, but nonetheless, let's give them their way. We take you now to Sydney, Australia for the main event.
That's right, 3D. Ha, ha, ha. And here we have Jay and the fat fucking marshmallow bear locking up.
Now, the fat marshmallow man, I happen to have secret information. Before he was Big Flame, before he was a big gay man with small titties, he was, in fact, a Southwest Detroit gang banger, in his
Whoa,
own words.
And an overseller.
He's that right now. Now, there you see Shaggy flying off the top rope, landing on the big padding of the loopy waterman.
Tremendous aerial skills and a skinny faggot going up and lands on Shaggy.
Now look at those fucking, what the, ladies and gentlemen. Jay's gonna do it. No, he grabs the feminine referee and throws him on the trio.
Why is he throwing my Shaggy for? What kind of shit was that?
Look at the sold out crowd in Australia watching this in complete shock.
Yes, the bleachers are full of crickets tonight.
There's the Rude Boy outside making sure his team of Jay, Shaggy, and Evil Dead are doing just fine in the ring. There's the feminine referee.
Here he comes back in the ring, the Stay Puff Bubble Homo.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to take this time to send a special shout out to the Seeds of Lotus, the6.com, realjuggalos.com, Riders.com, DarkLotus.net, and who else, Shaggy?
And Pearl Harbor!
All right, look at that. Beating the hell out of fucking Neil or Bob. I'm not sure which one that is.
We'll just call him the super skinny faggot.
Amazing clothesline.
The bird chest faggot goes down.
Now, what I'm looking for right now, is the super climax of the match. When Jay gets the hot tag and comes in with his standard 80 hip tosses.
Yes, that's a normal procedure in an RCP match, is the hot tag to Jay, hip toss, body slam, body slam.
Well, see, he needs to make the hot tag because he can't be the main faction of the match because he blows up too quick.
Well, you know, quick tags would always work in his situation. He don't blow up as fast as a horn-swoggling hillbilly, but nonetheless, he's a larger man.
Oh, let's see a tag to Evil Dead. The fans in Australia are going bananas.
The Evil Dead maniacs are running rampant.
I see a guy clapping in the background.
And I see the Rude Boy has their corner.
Here comes Evil Dead. Evil Dead, the JCW World Heavyweight Champion, with a kick to the midsection of the skinny faggot.
Now, anybody that's ever wrestled Evil Dead has personally told me, now if you watch him, his punches and kicks are real stiff. In the industry, we call them potatoes.
That's right. Now, Evil Dead is a very much a fan favorite amongst juggalos, but here in Sydney, Australia, there are hardly any juggalos, only wrestling fans in the crowd, and look at them, they're ecstatic.
Now here comes the buff faggot.
Now this buff faggot right here, I'm told he looks a lot like Redneck Devil Without a Cause from Volume 1, but that's just my speculation.
I'm going to go ahead and say he's really straight, one of the Dale brothers, although he is tag teaming with two actual faggots.
That's right. Now notice, everything he's doing has no effect on Evil Dead. Evil Dead is already dead, so nothing fucking hurts him. That's the benefit. You can chop him in the head. You can drop kick him. Fucking Haystacks could sit on his face for 15 minutes. Nothing matters. Evil Dead's already dead, and on top of that, he's fucking evil.
Now, 3D, that might be true, but for some reason, I think his balls are still alive, because whenever he takes that rope shot to the balls, it always seems to affect him.
Now, I'm told, Guido, that you're attracted to the shiny sequence butt of the buff faggot.
That's all pure speculation right now. Actually, I'm more attracted to the rotting anus of Evil Dead.
All right.
Now, did I just say that?
No, you didn't. All right, Evil Dead with enormous suplex.
The third suplex in a row.
That was almost like a snap suplex, that of Dynamite Kid. Now, Evil Dead climbing the ropes like King Kong climbed the Empire State Building, and he's gonna...
Shot that always affects his alive balls on his dead body.
That's right. Evil Dead is completely dead except for the penis scrotum area.
I don't know if his penis is alive, but his balls definitely are.
Guido would know.
Hey, wait a second. Shaggy might know, but I don't.
All right. Evil Dead. Smell of death. Smells of death. He is dead. He looks like Jump Steady under a mask, but that's always been speculation, and no Juggalo from any website has ever been able to prove anything.
Now, 3D, to me, it seems like you're calling this match a little biased. You're supposed to be a sportscast journalist and call it up the middle, but here comes the reverse ball shots. He knows that his gay balls are extra tender.
Now, I don't know why Evil Dead's doing the nut shots there to the buff faggot. Everybody knows the buff faggot has no balls. In fact, he has a pussy where his balls should be, and he has a penis and a pussy with no balls.
He's trying to stop him from regenerating more faggots.
Now, wait a minute. Evil Dead's been in the ring too long, and he's highly blown up.
Well, he doesn't move fast enough to blow up, although that rubber mask does restrict the air to his human face.
Look at Evil Dead cleaning the house. Boom!
Whoa.
The marshmallow fag right into the mat.
Stay Puff Homo goes down on his faggot face.
Stay Puff Homo almost looks like a bowl of oatmeal.
Now, if you notice,
and talking.
His stomach, when he's laying on his back, looks like some rising dough. A loaf of bread in the oven for the first 10 minutes.
He looks as if, there are two types of fat, ladies and gentlemen. There's the type of fat that Violent J is, which is a more stiff fat. And it's like Rude Boy.
He tags off the Shaggy. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
Rude Boy's got the stiff fat.
Yes, very hard.
Hard fat. But then there's the loopy oatmeal fat. That of that big pink homo right there.
Like in the instance of the Stay Puft bubble homo, I just want to cut the middle of his stomach open and lace it with butter. After that, you can use your own fucking mind.
Now, there's Shaggy with an incredible leg swipe swip.
That's right, he got that from Mr. Ass.
Now, Shaggy throws the skinny faggot into the ropes.
That's the buff faggot.
The buff faggot. Oh, over the top rope.
Into the rope
sailing.
And over the rope. Holy crap.
Guido, I have a question.
So,
why don't you suck my dick?
Jesus Christ, 3D, let's not start fights right now. We're supposed to be calling the match, not fighting with each other. We got a problem right here on this monitor.
Well, look at this right here. The crowd, in fact, is sold out, oversold.
Whoa, devastating move.
Sydney, Australia has never been the host to such violence, such wrestling expertise, such perfection in ring dwelling, if
3D,
you will.
To the amateur eye, that looks like an empty house. But for Australia, that's a sold-out packed Madison Square Garden, Wembley Stadium.
Now, you'll notice on the pink marshmallow faggot, he has a butthole on the front of his stomach. That butthole is host to holding foreign objects. That butthole is host to holding powder for the eyes. It's host to holding brass knuckles and other items.
Also, it's host to holding men's dicks.
Boom! Right there, suicide suplex slam.
He can hold all three of those men's dicks in the ring right now in one stroke.
There's a good shot of the hold. Notice the hole on the front of Marshmallow Faggot.
You can see it from a good half mile away on a clear day.
You could scream into that hole, wait 15 minutes, and you hear your scream return.
Super leg drop on the part of Violet J. Here comes another one.
Notice Violet J's looking great, as usual.
I think he might be blew up.
He is blew up. He did three moves already. Give him a fucking break. Oh, what?
What the fuck was that?
We'll see what.
Who is that supposed to hurt?
Well, that was, things go wrong in the ring sometimes, goddammit, Guido. Sometimes things don't go as planned.
Now, that's setting up for what we call the false hot tag.
Now, right here, look at the loopy man, the walking bowl of oatmeal. Easily slams the slender Violent J.
Pull your pink faggot pants up, you fucking homo faggot!
He heard you. Now shut up. Now notice this, the very light on his feet, lightweight, aerial, cruiserweight Violent J just being manhandled by this big fat guy.
Oh my God, look at the Stay Puft homo has a pussy on the front of him.
Now right, oh shit. Caught Jay right in the bearded clam.
I don't know. You might want to rewind that and check all the inches that it came from his face.
Oh, my God.
He pats the marshmallow.
Now, Jay's going to make a tag. Who's it going to be a tag to? Rude Boy, once again, on the apron, helping him tag to none other than Evil Rob. I mean, oh, no, Shaggy.
He would probably tag the Rude Boy, but he was still injured from a duel of a butcher.
Now Shaggy's going to square off against a skinny faggot. I'm going to go ahead and say the skinny faggot's going to knock the shit out of Shaggy.
He's a fucking asshole with a bird chest, and he gets his head punched off.
Right. Look at the sold-out crowd in the background.
Yes.
There's got to be at least 40 or 50,000 screaming wrestling fans.
Screaming crumpets in the crowd. Hello? Tremendous bump.
What the hell is the skinny homo doing?
He's shaking his faggot hips. He's trying to attract faggots and heterosexuals.
Now, wrestling is a work. Everybody knows that. But there's no way that's a work. That's too damn genuine for anybody to believe.
Now, you can see the buff faggot. He doesn't really shake his hips on like the fat guy and the fucking skinny bird chest guy.
Ooh, the pedophiler throws Shaggy into the ropes and gives him an enormous electrifying clothesline.
I'm going to go ahead and say that clothesline was a little oversold, Jay.
It might have been oversold, 3D. But Shaggy wants to show his aerial tactics. Right there, the pedophiler slapping the pepperonis of Shaggy Two-Dope.
You see the ginger gay slap in the corner?
Right there.
You can see his chick tits right through his pink shirt. Oh my God, if that would have connected, he could have broke his ribs.
Face full of boot! Face full of boot!
Holy shit, I'm surprised he didn't turn around and take it in the butt.
Now wait a minute, Shaggy's climbing the ropes. He's gonna give him the inverted dick throat. There it is.
Big dick. Flames, deep throat in his dick and his balls at the same time with a power bomb on top of it to add the insult to the dick suck.
Big Flame, without a doubt, one of the most feared gangbangers in Southwest Detroit. Feared all over elementary schools everywhere.
That's
known
right.
For pedophiling and kiddie porn. But that's purely speculation on my behalf.
His gang sign is the pink triangle.
Oh, my God. Right there, the skinny faggot delivers a head to the pussy of Shaggy Two Dope.
Look at every time the bird chest faggot stands up, he pushes his ass and chest out like a little flaming faggot.
Here comes the buff faggot, who looks a lot like our friend Chucky, brother of Billy Bill and Dougie Doug. But that's only because he looks like him. It's not because it is him or
now,
something.
I happen to know, beautiful elbow. That's before he injured himself and started landing on his feet first before the elbow.
Sydney, Australia is going berserk.
Sydney, Australia's never seen action like this before.
Including 3D. This match because it really happened in Maryland. But that's...
Shut your fucking mouth. No, it didn't. It happened in the Galapagos Islands in Sydney, Australia.
That's right. The Galapagos Islands were host to this great main event match.
That's right. Outside waiting for autographs afterwards were duck-billed platypuses and... Oh, Komodo dragons.
Look at the sexy dancing skills of the male prostitute. Boom! Drops a fucking elbow across the bird chest of Shaggy.
Now you notice when Shaggy's laying on his back like that, he likes to show off a little leg. He pulls his shorts up some.
That's right. In fact, I remember one WCW match where his shorts came up all the way over his hips, revealing his G-string bikini underwear.
Here comes the power fag move. It's called the butthole reamer.
Oh, he misses it.
If he would have hit that, Shaggy would have had his butthole reamed.
Now, right here, Sydney, Australia was in shock after this move. Watch Shaggy. Oh, just missing the soft marshmallow head of Shaggy.
I think he might have cried. There goes the sexy legs again.
A Violent J standing in the back, showing off those sexy legs.
He wants the hot tag. He's asking for the hot tag. He's calling for the hot tag. He knows the hip tosses are close.
Now, if Jay gets his tag, you will see standard mid-80s Mike Rotundo hip tosses. You will see, there it is.
Here comes the hot tag. Who's first?
Soft
marshmallow
punch.
Faggot. Soft chest faggot.
Soft clothesline. Here comes Bushwhacker Luke hip
tosses. And he falls.
Bushwhacker hip toss. Yes.
Here comes
Bushwhacker hip toss. Boom, once again.
Now, what's he going to do to the marshmallow homo?
He's going to throw him into the ropes and give him a ginger backdrop, I think.
Easy.
Slow. Oh, he picks him up. Boom.
He ran into that rope pretty slow.
Now, what's going to happen right here? Tag back to Shaggy. It looks like things are coming to a close. Shaggy and Violent J grabbing the buff faggot.
I'm going to go ahead and say the marshmallow faggot doesn't really have any wrestling skills. He's just got super gay skills. There it is, the finishing move.
Shaggy.
They fucked it all up, though.
The feminine referee counts 1, 2, 3, and Jay, Shaggy, and Evil Dead, accompanied by the Rude Boy, are victorious.
That's right. That was kind of a quick count, too, because the faggot referee wanted to hurry up and get the match over so all four of them could hit the showers together.
That's right. Now, this crowd in Sydney, Australia was stunned. After this match, I'll be happy to let you know that sales of Insane Clown Posse's Bizarre Bizarre album went up a notch.
That's right. It went from 489 to 487.
Right before falling completely off the charts.
That's right. Now, charts in Sydney, Australia go up to 500.
Now, look at Shaggy Two-Dope stud shot right there.
He got that shot done at the Glamour Shots up at the mall. You can tell by the glare in his eyes.
The tag team champions and Evil Dead right there. This match was filmed actually moments before Evil Dead lost the world title to Briar Wellington.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to thank all the wrestlers in JCW. I'm Handsome Harley Quistella, better known as 3D.
And nobody cares.
Wait a second, Guido, I mean.
Whatever. I'm Violent. I'm somebody. Bye. No, I'm Handsome.
Naked match.